All right, to get you set for this one, we say hello to NHL.com correspondent Dave McCarthy. Dave, let's start with Philip Forsberg. Could make his return tonight after missing the last 17 games. Preds fans very excited to see him on the ice with the team this morning. Is there any update on his status?
Well, he was activated off the injured reserve earlier this afternoon, so that's another good sign that he's getting close to a return. I asked Peter Laviolette this morning, how close is he? He said, very close. I said, does that mean he's a possibility? He said, that means he's a possibility. PK Subban was talking as though Philip Forsberg would be back in the lineup for the first time since November the 29th, and Philip himself said, well, it's up to the coach, so I don't know, find me a coach that has a guy the caliber of Philip Forsberg ready to go and doesn't put him in the lineup.
Well said by you. On the other side of the equation tonight for Toronto, Michael Hutchinson set to make his third straight start with Anderson still out. Could he challenge Sparks for the backup role based on the way that he has played and continues to play?
It's an interesting question because I think that's one of the lingering questions around the Toronto Maple Leafs so far this season. It's will Garrett Sparks be able to solidify himself in a backup role? His record is good, but just when you watch the games, he's been a little bit, active in the net. I think that's the best way you can put it. And guys who seem to have success in the NHL seem to be very quiet in the net. He needs to get to a point where he can refine his game, cut out some of the unnecessary movements that have at times cost him. Michael Hutchinson's come up. He's played two really good games. Played great against the Vancouver Canucks on Saturday in a shutout. He said, you know what, not to say getting a shutout is easy, but he said, by and large, that was an easy game because the guys played so well in front of me. But Babcock also gave Hutchinson credit after the game and said, you know what, he made the saves he needed to make. He didn't turn one chance into a two or three or four chancer by kicking rebounds out and making it harder for himself than he needed to. So he's played really well. Thursday you can kind of throw out when he came in. He was called up that morning. They played at 2 p.m. He said, kind of felt like a rent-a-goalie that day. I hadn't met any of the guys, hadn't had a practice with the team. It was just show up to the rink at 2 p.m. and stop the puck, bud. So he did his best. But he put in a really good bid on Saturday against Vancouver. This is going to be an interesting test against a quality team in the Nashville Predators. If he puts another good performance forward, you have to wonder if the question creeps into the minds of Mike Babcock and Kyle Dubas. I will say this, though. I don't think Garrett Sparks will lose his job now. I think he's going to get the opportunity to play himself back into the backups role when he gets back from a concussion. But I will say this. It's given the Leafs management food for thought that if Sparks continues to struggle or they lack confidence in him, Hutchinson may be a viable option.
Well, Hutchinson's got a tough test tonight against the Nashville Predators, one of the best teams in the league. We heard Mike Babcock before our conversation talking about how he felt like his team wasn't as dialed in after the holiday break as they were before it. He liked their performance on Saturday. But what does Toronto need to do against the likes of the Predators tonight?
Well, the Predators, Jackie, are one of these playoff season teams, right? They play a playoff style of game. And what I mean by that is they're heavy, they're machine-like, they grind you down throughout the course of a game. And it'll be a real good test for the Maple Leafs that at times have liked to play a run-and-gun type of style. But against teams like Tampa and Boston earlier in the season that play that heavier style where they lean on you, Toronto hasn't had as much success. So the blueprint was really set out on Saturday against the Vancouver Canucks. As Babcock says all the time, they started on time, they got out to a good lead, they were up going into the third period, and then they didn't take their foot off the gas and let the game get away from them. They kept the foot on the gas and ran away with the game in the third period. Auston Matthews said this morning, that's the mark of a really good team. When you can go into the third period with a lead and then hammer the gas and just, you know, essentially skate away with the game. That's what they did on Saturday against Vancouver. That's really got to be the recipe for success, not just tonight against Nashville, but going forward down the stretch and into the second half.
Well, it's certainly the game of the night on tonight's NHL Sked. The Leafs playing host to the Preds. Thanks for this, Dave. We appreciate it. Enjoy the game.